Hello guys, welcome to Deep's Anatomy. In the previous video, we talked about the anatomy of adrenal gland and all about endocrinology. Today, we are going to talk about the anatomy of the liver and blood supply of the liver. So here we go. Liver is the largest gland in our body and it performs exocrine and metabolic function of the body. Liver is located in the right hypochondric region and proper epigastric region. A small part of the liver is located in the left hypochondric region. If we talk about the scalotopy of the liver, it lies at the level of 10th rib, or we can say 10th intercostal space, and then lifts to the 4th rib, passing through the sternum a little bit upward from the xiphoid process. Liver is made up of the hepatic cell and indistinct from the cincium. Bile is secreted continuously by the hepatic cells into the bile capillaries, from where it is collected by hepatic ducts, which joins the cystic ducts to form a common bile duct. Now let's talk about the structure of the liver. As we can see in the diagram, we have two lobes. The right and left lobe. Here we can see inferiorly, and behind we see gallbladder, and this is said to be as a Gleason's capsule, which is named by the British scientist, and this is falciparum ligament, which separates two lobe. And on the anterior superiorly we see coronary ligaments. This we see here is said to be as a right lobe, and this we see here said to be as a left lobe. As we know that the liver is made up of hepatic cells, which are the functional unit of the liver. If we go through the cross section of only one cell, we see here that the functional unit of the liver is hepatic cells, or we can say hepatic lobule. It consists of the central vein and a bile duct, and a branch of the hepatic portal vein and a branch of the hepatic portal hepatic artery, and a middle we see central vein. So this is we say central vein, and after that this is bile duct, or we can say bile hepatic duct, or after that we see here is said to be as a hepatic artery, and this is said to be as a hepatic vein. These all are just branches of these old arteries from here, and by coloring we can just easily determine the whole structure of a functional unit of the liver, which is said to be as a hepatic lobule. After that we see we have some visceral impressions on the visceral side. First we see the liver is attached to the renal, so we have the renal surface, and after some part is attached to the adrenal surface, we have the adrenal surface, and after that we see there is also duodenal surface, which is attached to the duodenal part of the intestine. And again we see oesophageal surface, and we have a colic surface, or on these we can also said to be as impressions, or we can say surface, but the impression will be the better word for that, these things. Now we are going to talk about blood supply of the liver, which is said to be as a hepatic circulation. Hepatic blood flow is 1500 ml per minute. Liver receives 80%, means 1200 ml per minute from the hepatic portal vein. And 20% means 300 ml per minute is delivered by hepatic artery. The blood flows from the heart to the liver through hepatic artery. Hepatic artery blood O2 content is 19 ml per deciliter. Hepatic vein blood O2 content is 13.4 ml per deciliter. If we go through the total blood supply to the hepatic portal vein is said to be as a hepatic artery minus hepatic vein O2 difference will be 19 minus 13.4 deciliter will be 5.6 ml. So after all, total O2 contained in the hepatic portal vein will be 16.8. The pressure of the hepatic artery is said to be as 100 mmHg. Hepatic vein supplies deoxygenated blood from the liver to the heart. And if we talk about the hepatic vein pressure is 5 mmHg. From the posterior inferiorly, we see bile duct. Which goes to the gastrointestinal tract. Hepatic portal vein carries blood from the gastrointestinal tract and gallbladder, spleen, pancreas to the largest gland, which is said to be as a liver and which is a main supply to the bile duct. So hepatic portal vein supplies blood and all to the spleen, pancreas to the largest gland said to be as liver. So this we see hepatic artery and this we see gastrointestinal tract and